Welcome to another episode of Phrases and Sayings. This is a series we haven't hit up in a while, actually. I was actually going to just kind of deadlock, not really talk about anything today, but as I was just going to like make a vlog, just kind of saying the short few things that are on my mind at the moment, but as I was doing it, I came across a phrase, and I was like, you know what? I'm going to talk about this. So today, as title implies, we're going to talk about the phrase, beat a dead horse. Or there's no point in beating a dead horse. Now, for those of you who live under a rock and have never heard this phrase before, it basically means, when you say there's no point in beating the dead horse, it just means there's no point in wasting energy on something that has been discussed but is impossible to change from the point it's at. A good example of this is an event that once it's done, it's done. For example, a presidential election. It is possible to change, but you would need a lot of individuals, and if it's just one person doing it, it's basically beating a dead horse. One person alone cannot change that kind of thing. They'd be wasting energy. However, if it's a large group of people, that's different. So let's use another example kind of to give an idea. A purchase. Say someone makes a purchase that you don't agree with, someone you know, like a really close friend or a family member, and the person, you know, decides to make the purchase for their own reason. You approach them and try to get on to them about it. Quite frankly, you're beating a dead horse. If the person is hooked on their choice and they think themselves that it is good in that factor, then yeah, you're beating a dead horse. You're wasting your breath on something you yourself cannot change. Sure, it may be able to be changed, but it's beating a dead horse when all you're doing is nagging at someone for their choice when you can do nothing about it. Going back to the purchase thing, say, like, I'm the one who purchased the Wii, by the way. A couple weeks ago, I believe, there was a video that went up that showcased Amber and I getting a Wii. I was the one who bought it for her and I to use for games like Just Dance. Now, if I bought it myself and Amber disagreed with it, you could probably bet that she probably would have gotten on to me for it, but she'd be beating a dead horse, because knowing me, when it comes to stuff like this, when I have certain aspects and reasons for why I do it, you can't change my mind. Say I bought the system and the games to go with it. I think she's the one who actually got the games, but I got the system. Under that front, if I got everything and she didn't agree with any of it, it'd be exactly that. She'd be nagging at me for nothing. I'd be like, what's done is done. There's nothing you can do about it. Either there's only one thing you can do about it, and that would be throw it away. But if you did that, I'd just buy another one when I can. It'd be wasting more finances over time. Kind of an idea like that. Either way around, that kind of disagreement, argument, whatever you want to call it, it's beating a dead horse, because you're wasting your breath on something you yourself cannot change. A good example, another really good example that's outside of purchasing, would actually be choice and decision. Say you're given several options for, I don't know, something medical. I bring up medical because it's the first thing that came to my mind, and I had medical stuff on my mind. outside of her, because I don't believe in the idea of needing permission from another individual to marry one specific individual. I'm not a firm believer in that. To each their own for those who do believe in that, and I can understand where it comes from, but I personally just don't. So when I proposed to her, if I remember correctly, I'm pretty sure both sets of parents weren't happy, not because of the decision I made, but because of the fact that they weren't approached first. I was like, mentally, I don't think I said it out loud, but what I just said is where my mind was on that front. They ended up finding out. And each had different types of conversations to make, but both were kind of in a sense where they were like, you should have done this first. The first time around, makes sense. However, that's all they did. They both did it once. However, if they were to do it multiple times after the fact, that's where my brain would start going, you're beating a dead horse, you're wasting your time. What's done is done, I'm not retracting my claim, I'm not retracting the proposal, it's not happening. That's a perfect example of when somebody's beating a dead horse. Now bear in mind, the second half that I presented is completely hypothetical. It did not happen in real life. Both sets of parents questioned why it went down the way it went down once, then dropped it. I want to clarify that. It was just the idea gave off a kind of a hypothetical scenario that would have been a perfect example of this. I just want to clarify that. These two examples are probably some of the best examples I can think of when it comes to the phrase, beat a dead horse. When you beat a dead horse, you're wasting time, breath, energy, and quite frankly, mental capacity. What's the point in doing it? Let me retract that word. The one word if. For me, there's a reason why. When I go into things, I'm like, if it doesn't impact me, I don't get involved in it. For example, I'm gonna bring up the presidency election example again just for this particular aspect of it, just because I think it works a bit better here. When a president is elected, unless the decisions said individual who's elected makes impacts me specifically or anybody I directly know in an extremely negative way, I just let it go over my head. Because what's the point? If it doesn't impact me in any kind of way or anybody close to me, I just don't actually, that part might not be true, but you get the point. Back at that point in time, I had a similar mindset of, unless it impacts me negatively, don't get involved. There's no point in beating a dead horse. However, what if the horse is persistent and not quite dead? That's different. In the case of whom I'm referring to, that's exactly what was going on. Sometimes on topics, it just, the topic is avoided and it's not directly addressed with, like, evidence, more or less. In the case of what I'm referring to, what happened was that I got skeptical of what was going on. So I approached my ex about it, and she claimed nothing bad was happening, but I was getting this rotten feeling. It could have been beat a dead horse. It could have. Except for one teeny tiny detail. One of the people who she was cheating on me with actually reached out to me wondering who I was. It was one of the other people that. It was three people overall, including myself. So one of the other two actually reached out to me and wondered who I was. I told the truth, or at least from what I knew. At that point, I was fully aware that it wasn't beating a dead horse. It was beating a temperamental, live one. As of, like, 4 months after that, it would have been beating a dead horse because I refused to talk to the person after that. The last time I spoke with this ex, I screamed at her and told her never get a hold of me again. Blocked her on all social media accounts, blocked her phone number, haven't heard from her since. Quite frankly, it benefited me. There's no point in being a dead horse. Once I realized it was a dead horse, I buried it and never confronted the topic again. This is a perfect example of how that should be approached compared to what a lot of people do. A lot of people do still beat a dead horse. They'll hold on to that kind of thing for a very long time. And the only reason I brought it up is it's just a good example. It's not particularly that it bothers me anymore. In fact, if it did, it would be kind of pathetic because it's been a couple years since the event. It doesn't bother me at all. Makes me glad I have Pink Fox. But there are some people who are out there who will hold on to it, hold a grudge. Holding grudges is basically what beating a dead horse is. And it's just sad. Regardless, though, I feel like if I were to try to talk about this anymore, I'd be going on a loop. But my thoughts, kind of as a synopsis of people who beat a dead horse, I just think they're wasting their time. This is a personal opinion. Maybe there are reasons behind it. I'm sure under certain circumstances there actually are, but in which case it's not really beating a dead horse, it's just beating a persistent one. Either way, what are your guys' thoughts on this phrase? Let us know in the comments below. If you like this video, make sure to push that like button. It's so far you can't sit anymore. If you really like this kind of stuff, consider